Akan Baran.
Thank you. The next speaker is Mr. Ravindra Kumar, K. Ravindra Kumar.
Yes. Sir, Honorable Chairman, sir, I am very much thankful to you for giving this opportunity to speak on the dam safety bill. This bill is mandated to provide surveillance, inspection, operation and maintenance of the specified dam offer, prevention of dam failure, related disasters, and to provide for institutional mechanism to ensure their safe functioning and for matters connected thereto or incidental thereto. Sir, dams have played a key role in rapid, sustainable agricultural and rural growth of our country. There are about 5,254 dams which are completely constructed, about 447 dams are under construction, out of which 293 are more than 100 years old and 1,000 dams are under 52 years old. In Andhra Pradesh, Prakasam Barrage and Dhabaleswaram and other barrages are more than 50 dams are old in and the reservoirs are also there. It has to be addressed and looked into. Sir, Polavaram project in the state of Andhra Pradesh was given the status of national project in pursuance of the AP Reorganization Act. The project construction was in full swing till 2019. Subsequently, the progress of the said project is very slow. Earlier, the technical committee approved the revised DPR of about 55,000 crores. Till now, it has not been finalized. During Sri Nara Chandrababu Naidu Garu regime till 2019, the state spent its money and bring it to this stage, and thereafter the state government is not in a position to invest any money on this project. I request the Honorable Minister to be magnanimous and generous towards Andhra Pradesh and to see that the revised DPR has to be approved and released. Polavaram project is to be completed in a time-bound manner. The only 2 years is left out of 10 years. In respect of clause 24 of the bill, states like Tamil Nadu, Kerala, etc. have expressed their strong reservations on this bill since it is encroaching upon the rights of the states. As per clause 24, clause 1, subclause 1, the entire powers of authority will vested with the National Committee. On dam safety, because some of the dams belongs to one state and it is being situated in another state, both the states should be given priority in the National Committee. As per clause 18 of the National Dam Safety Authority, shall be chaired by an officer not below the rank of the additional secretary to the Government of India, but he is not a technical person. A competent technical person has to be appointed to head of the authority along with the other members. As per clause 3A, the decision of the authority shall be final and binding on the parties to the issue. It shows there is no appellate authority to question the decision of the single member authority. It is not advisable legally. The bill does not define the term of stakeholders. Similarly, the bill does not focus on the operational safety, only focused on the structural safety. As per clause 5 of the bill deals with the composition of the National Committee on Dam Safety, clause 5(1)(c) not exceeding 7 representatives of the state government of the level of engineering in charge are equivalent to by rotation nominated by the central government. The central government is appointing only 7 members from 29 states on rotation basis. For example, one member appointed from the state of Andhra Pradesh, his term will expire by 2023. If rotation is being calculated, the Andhra Pradesh will get next chance for only 2038. This will create so many problems. Therefore, I request the Honorable Minister to consider to give representations to all the states in the committee like GST Council. Nothing will cause any harm to provide similar provisions to the National Committee on Dam Safety. Since our country having a federal structure, it is not advisable neither desirable to encroach upon the rights of the issue. One more important issue is concerned as far as Krishna River is concerned. There are 4 states consisting of Maharashtra, Karnataka, Telangana and AP. There is a long-standing dispute with regard to the Krishna River distribution of the water. There is in the upper riparian states are getting benefit, lower riparian states are not getting water in the absence of rainy season. And the proportionate release is very much required. Dam safety is not only important, equivalently proportionate release of the water in all royal riparian states also to be given priority. Apart from that, the lower riparian states shall be given absolute right with regard to the water which are going to the sea. that is to be, first priority has to be taken into consideration. The Honorable Minister, I request you to consider to surplus water can be utilized by the, with absolute rights, by the lowest riparian states. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Next speaker is Sanjay Singh.